Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Honorable Chairman and my dear friends, today I would like to speak about the Islamic Renaissance of Kerala Muslims. We can define the Renaissance, it is a resurrection from the sovereignty of religion to the literature, language and knowledge. But we can tell about the Islamic Renaissance because we can find in Islamic sovereignty of religion. But we have to understand about the Kerala Muslims, because Kerala Muslims can and could make a big change in the situation and instructive situation of Kerala. Kerala Muslim scholars give the good face to the Kerala culture. The tradition of Kerala Islamic started after the arriving of Malik bin Dinar and his group. That time, the bourgeoisie didn't consider the value of the human. But the growth of the Islam could change the situation. That time, if anyone wear the Muslim cap, he will be considered as a man. By the hands of Muslim scholars, so many people feel the light of the freedom. We can understand about the influence of Kerala Muslim scholars in the hearts of Kerala people from the words of Barbosa. He told the roaming youths and children sold the governor to the Muslims. That time the Muslims make their mind to the Islams. They received the Islams because they were wanting the freedom. Mainly, the Dar system gave the power to the Islamic Renaissance of Kerala. So that so many scholars went to the world of the different area of the world from there to teach the fiqh from Shafi Mazhab. The Poinani is main center of the Dar system. As well as so many famous Renaissance leaders arised from there. In the 9th century, the Muslims can give the many literature skills to the Islamic. That time, many poems and many books composed to spread the excitement to attack and the protest against the colonial. The Fathul Mubin and Tafril and other books composed for to spread the excitement against the colonial. The Fathul Mubin is the invaluable present of Kerala Muslims people. That by the reason of the Fathul Mubin, the Kerala Islamic scholars famous are in the world. This book is a syllabus test in the Malaysia and Sri Lanka and Egypt, these countries. We can understand the Umar Khali and Zainuddin Makhdum and Sayyid Alawi al-Mamburam. They were the real Renaissance leaders. The Umar Khali refused the tax before the Gandhiji. Gandhiji refused the tax in 1920. So we can tell Gandhi is the first defiant person the tax. Before the Umar Khali refused the tax before the Gandhi, not only he announced Indian, he has the strength of believing, he has never lived as a surrender of the under the British East India Company. To attack against the Portuguese, the Zainuddin Makhdum wrote a poem, the name of that, Tahreer Ahl Iman Ala Jihadi Abadati Sulban. That is a very inspiration of the people to attack against the colonial. By the reason of that, Malik bin Dinar and his group came the Kozhikode from the Kochi. As well as the Sayyid Alawi al-Mamburam carried a big role in the Islamic Renaissance of Kerala. William Logan says about the Sayyid Alawi al-Mamburam, the Sayyid Alawi al-Mamburam gave the big inspiration to the people to attack against the people. The fatwa of Sayyid Alawi al-Mamburam is a big inspiration and Malabar and Turkey to attack against the people and attack against the colonial mind. So that we can tell our Renaissance leaders worked for poor. Our Renaissance leaders worked with poor. But this time, the people underestimate about the Renaissance leaders. All are considering as a Renaissance leaders the Wakam Abdul Qadir Maulavi and Sanaullah Makti Tangal. But we can tell about here, there is the Norian Renaissance leaders of Kerala. We can tell the came of that, the lost purity of Islam. They are wanting the Renaissance leaders. But we have to understand and we should oppress these crazy people and we should erase the real Renaissance leaders. I can't hold my words.